This is Duane Friend with University of Illinois Extension. There are areas on the earth, near large mountains, that are very dry or desert-like. These dry areas are called rain shadow areas. What causes a rain shadow? When wind flows up a mountain, the air is moving into an area that has lower air pressure, making the rising air expand and cool. When air cools, its capacity to hold moisture in the form of water vapor decreases. Water vapor is the gaseous form of water. As air continues to rise up the mountain, it cools to the point it's at its maximum capacity to hold water vapor. When air is at its maximum capacity, it is at 100% relative humidity. Further cooling will cause excess water vapor to condense or turn into liquid water. This forms clouds. If enough condensation occurs, rain or snow will fall out of the clouds. As long as the air continues to rise up the mountain, condensation, clouds, and possibly rain or snow will occur. The side of the mountain where wind is flowing up the mountain is called the windward side. Many areas of the world experience large amounts of rain or snow where air is forced up mountains. The western parts of Oregon and Washington states are good examples of this process. As air flows down the other side, or the lee side of the mountain, it starts to warm. The warming is caused by the air getting squeezed together as it moves downward into higher air pressure. Warmer air can hold more water vapor, so condensation does not occur when air is sinking. If there is no condensation, there are no clouds, and therefore no rainfall. Dry or desert conditions prevail on the lee side and are known as the rain shadow area. Eastern parts of Oregon and Washington are examples of where the rain shadow occurs. While Laurel Mountain in western Oregon receives over 119 inches of yearly precipitation, Bend, Oregon, on the lee side of the mountains, receives only about 12 inches of precipitation a year. Large differences in climate will be experienced depending on which side of the mountain you happen to be on.